أعوذ بالله السميع العليم العظيم الحفيظ الوجه الكريم والسلطان القديم من الرجس الخبيث المخبث الشيطان اللئيم الرجيم وكبيله ونفيه ونفسه وهمزه بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ولقد آتيناك سبعا من المثاني والقرآن العظيم صدق الله مولانا العلي العظيم وبلغنا رسوله النبي الكريم ونحن على ذلك لمن الشاهدين والشاكرين والحمد لله رب العالمين إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وآبائه محمد وآل محمد وصحبه محمد وآله وسلم ولقد آتيناك سبعا من المثاني والقرآن العظيم سورة الحج verse number 87 Allah Ta'ala said Walakat, wo means and, lakat means indeed. Atainaka, we gave to you sabam min al masani, sabam min al masani, and wal Quran al azim, glorious Quran al majid. Yani Allah Ta'ala, it means that Allah Ta'ala gave to Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam two things, sabam min al masani and Quran al azim. But no one can know meaning, what is the meaning of sabam min al masani? You know the lexical meaning, but not actual meaning. Lexical meaning, sabam means seven, masani means repeated. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is our guide. And Allah Ta'ala said in Quran Majeed, وَيُعَلِّمُهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةِ Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will teach you and tell you the explanation of and commentary of the verses. So what is the actual meaning of sabam min al-masani? Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will tell us. So, Imam Ahmad recorded in his book, Musnad Imam Ahmad, on the authority of Hazrat Abu Hurairah radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Suratul Fatiha is a Ummul Kitab, Ummul Quran, mother of book, mother of Quran Majeed. And Wahiya, Sab'ul Masani, and Surah Al-Fatiha is Sab'am Min Al-Masani. Another Hadith Mubarak, Abu Sa'id Rafi, reported, the Messenger of Allah said to me, shall I teach you the greatest surah in Quran and Majeed? Hazrat Abu Sa'id said, then Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam took me by the hand. When we were about to step out, I reminded of his promise to teach me the greatest surah in Quran and Majeed. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, yes, I know. It is Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen Hiya Sab'ul Masani. The greatest surah in Quran Majeed is Surah Al-Fatiha. And that is Sab'ul Masani, seven repeated verses. In the light of this Hadith Mubarakah, Sab'ul Masani means Surah Al-Fatiha. Another Hadith Mubarakah. Hadrat Ubay ibn Ka'b radiyallahu ta'ala anhu and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam both were offering the namaz in Masjid al-Aqsa. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam finished his namaz and went away. But Hadrat Ubay ibn Ka'b radiyallahu ta'ala anhu still was in namaz. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam called him. Obey, he did not answer. He was still busy in namaz. Again Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Obey, he did not finish his namaz, not stop his namaz, not answer. Rapidly, faster, he finished his namaz. Then went to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, what prevented you answering me? Ya Rasulullah, I was in namaz.
Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, did you not read what Allah Ta'ala sent down to me? Then Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam recited, Ya ayyuhal ladheena amanu stajibu lillahi wa lirrasooli iza da'akum lima yujikum. Allah Ta'ala said in Quran al-Majeed, O you believer, answer Allah, answer Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when he calls. Did you not read this? Ya Rasulullah, I will not do it again. When you call, I will stop my namaz. First of all, I will answer you. Then I will stop my namaz. Ya ayyuhal ladheena amanu istajibu lillahi wa lirrasooli iza da'akum. So, the scholars said, if you are offering namaz, then Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam calls you. So stop your namaz. Stop the worship of Allah. First of all, answer to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then come back and start your namaz. This is the status and rank of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to Ubay, Ubay ibn Ka'b radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. Ubay, shall I teach you of the greatest surah in Quran? Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when said, I will teach you, Ubay ibn Ka'b said, when we came close to that door, I said, O Messenger of Allah, what is the surah that you have promised me? Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that is surah Fatiha, which is Sab'ul Masani. So in the light of these two hadith mubarakah, Sab'ul Masani means Suratul Fatiha. And Suratul Fatiha is the greatest surah in Quran al-Majeed. So, translate again. وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَاكَ سَبْعًا مِنَ الْمَسَانِي وَالْقُرْآنَ الْعَزِيمِ وَمُحَمَّدْ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَآلِهِ وَسَلَّمْ I gave to you Surah Fatiha in Quran. Surah Fatiha is also called As-Salah, the Salah in Urdu, the Namaz. The Surah Fatiha has another meaning, the Salah, the Namaz. Why? Because reciting it is a condition for completion of Salah. Ahadith al-Mubarakah in Musnad Imam Ahmad. Whoever performs any prayer, Sunan, Nawafil, Faraiz, any prayer, whoever offers, performs any prayer in which he did not recite Surah Al-Fatiha, his prayer is incomplete. And another hadith al-Mubarakah, there is no prayer, la salata, liman lam yaqra li Fatiha al-Kitab. There is no prayer for whoever does not recite the Fatiha. This is mentioned in Muslim Sharif. But these both hadith al-Mubarakah for that person who is offering individually. If you are offering namaz behind Imam Sahib, then you will not recite Surah Fatiha and not from anything Quran and Jinn. Why? The first proof is this, and first thing is this, Allah Ta'ala ordered in Quran and Jinn, listen carefully, is a very important masala, burning question. Allah Ta'ala said in Quran and Jinn, وَإِذَا قُرِيَ الْقُرْآنُ فَاسْتَمِعُوا لَهُ وَأَنْسِتُوا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. Whenever, when Quran is recited, إِذَا قُرِيَ الْقُرْآنُ Quran is recited, وَانْسَتُوا Be quiet. Listen carefully. Be quiet. So when Imam Sahib is reciting Surah Fatiha, when Imam Sahib is reciting any part from Quran al-Majeed, you cannot recite behind Imam Sahib, because Allah Ta'ala is saying, when Quran is recited, be quiet. وَإِذَا قُرِيَ الْقُرْآنُ فَاسْتَمِعُوا لَهُ Listen carefully. وَانْسَتُوا Be quiet. And if Imam Sahib is Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen reciting, and you are reciting also Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, you are fighting with Imam Sahib. Therefore, one day, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was leading in prayer. One person is reciting Quran behind Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam finished his namaz, he said, who is fighting with me? Who is fighting with me? Yani,
I am reciting the Quran Majeed and you are also reciting Quran Majeed behind me. At that time you chose a person. He will talk to Allah Ta'ala on behalf of you. So be quiet and listen what he is saying to Allah Ta'ala on behalf of you. So when Imam Sahib is reciting Quran Majeed, you cannot recite Surah Al-Fatiha. Be quiet, listen carefully what he is saying. But the other question, when Imam Sahib is not reciting Allah, means in Zuhr Namaz and in Asr Namaz, and then to listen another Hadith Mubarak. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, memorize and remember. Bahtishan. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever performs his prayer behind an imam. This hadith mentioned in Baqi Sharif. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever performs his prayer behind an imam, the imam's recitation would be considered his recitation. Qiraatul imam, qiraatul lahu. Imam's recitation, imam's reading would be considered his reading. So when Imam Sahib is reciting Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, be quiet. At that time he is your imam. Don't try to fight with Imam Sahib. And another Hadith Mubarak. Musnad Imam Ahmad, volume 3, page 148. Narrated Abu Hurairah, imam was appointed to be followed by. So Nabi Sahib was appointed to be followed by. Don't try to be go ahead Imam Nabi Sahib. So when Nabi Sahib is reciting Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, to be quiet, to be followed by. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when Imam said takbirat, yani Allahu Akbar, you say Allahu Akbar. And when Imam start to recite the Quran Majeed, be quiet. It is the order Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to you. When Imam start to recite the Quran Majeed, be quiet. This hadith is mentioned in Musnad Imam Ahmad. So when you are behind Imam Sahib, be quiet. You cannot recite Surah Al-Fatiha.